ये लो।
गुड न्यूज सर, आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा।
20%? 20%?
लॉटरी लग गई तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे लूटे डाले।
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना। 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए, रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए, 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा। बात तो वही है ना।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
मैंने सोच लिया है, जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना, तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा।
क्यों?
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं, तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना।
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे? प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
ये लो।
गुड न्यूज सर, आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा।
20%? 20%?
लॉटरी लग गई तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे लूटे डाले।
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना। 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए, रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए, 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा। बात तो वही है ना।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
We've come here to participate in the PCRA Saksham quiz.
I'm very happy to participate in this level of PCRA quiz competition.
We want to thank PCRA organization to give us an opportunity to represent Assam in this stage.
We'd like to thank PCRA for giving us an opportunity to come here.
I will participate in PCRA quiz competition.
The matter of petroleum conservation is an alarming issue. We all should conserve petroleum resources because these resources will not last for long.
PCRA is an association which has taken the initiative to conserve resources so that we can conserve it for the future.
Environment protection and climate change are some of the issues that every child is to be made aware about, and it all starts from the grassroots level.
Petroleum and all the natural resources available to us are getting depleted day by day. So what we can do with, we can put our hands together in order to conserve them. We can use alternative sources like biofuels instead of petroleum and all.
In our school we do many programs for these environmental issues, and sometimes every month we do plantation program.
After coming this far, we don't want to go back now, so we will give it our best so that we can head on to the nationals.
मुझे यहाँ पर आके बहुत अच्छी लग रही है, मैं जरूर जीतूंगी।
No guts, no glory, no greatness, no story. Namaskar and welcome to the third thrilling zonal final of India's favorite conservation quiz. PCRA presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2020. Greatness requires an extreme desire and passion to do what one sets out to do. And today, these teams from Indian Energizers are here to begin their story on the path to greatness. Glory beckons. Doordarshan Studio, City of Joy, Kolkata, se main hu aapka host Ajay Punia, aur karenge thodi masti, thoda magic. Mere saath Eastern India se aaye 6 exciting Indian Energizers. वेस्ट और साउथ से अपनी जर्नी तय करने के बाद हमारी सक्षम एयरलाइंस आ पहुंची है अब ईस्ट। सो फास्टन योर सीट बेल्ट्स बिकॉज इन 2 जोनल क्वालिफायर्स ऑफ 3 टीम्स ईच आर इंडियन एनर्जाइजर्स आर रेडी टू कम्पीट। फ्रॉम ईच ऑफ द क्वालिफायर्स वी सिलेक्ट 2 टीम्स फ्रॉम द जोनल फाइनल, एंड फ्रॉम द फैंटास्टिक 4 जोनल फाइनलिस्ट वी सिलेक्ट 1 टीम, द बेस्ट वन फॉर द नेशनल फाइनल एट दिल्ली। and the winners at Delhi, the champions of India will board the Saksham Airlines to the land of sushi, sumo wrestling and Shinkansen trains, Japan. If that's not tempting, I wonder what is. And of course, with me in the studio is a lovely set of audience members from three different schools. Kendriya Vidyalaya Fort William, RKSM Sister Nivedita Girls School and Baranagar Ramakrishna Mission Ashram High School in the studio to cheer us along the way. Thank you and welcome all of you here. Now, before we begin, let me tell you why we're here. We are here because of Petroleum Conservation Research Association, a society under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Yeh hai Saksham, Sanrakshan Shamta Mahotsav, ke one of three national level competitions for school students, essay, painting and quiz. Aur in sabhi ke piche, sirf ek irada, to promote fuel conservation and energy efficiency. So, online round, district round or state round jeetne ke baad, agar humare Indian Energizers ki battery hai charged, toh we will start our first of two qualifiers. Starting from table A, we have Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya from Sikkim, represented by Susongmut Lepcha and Eli Soba. Then on table B, we have Guru Gobind Singh Public School from Bokaro, Jharkhand, represented by Arvind Kumar Sharma and Harshal Singh. And then finally, on table C, on my left, is the team from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya, Papampare, Arunachal Pradesh, represented by Tadar Tata and Bengya Tagu. Super. So now we shall begin this celebration of the enabler of life, our beautiful planet, planet Earth. You will have two rounds of quizzing. I'll explain to you the rounds one by one. Let's begin with round number one on your screen. There will be three multiple choice questions, one question to each team. Other teams, of course, you can hit the buzzer, but do not answer immediately. Wait for the direct team to give me their answer. If the direct team gives me an answer, they get 10 points, but no negatives if you are wrong. There will be four choices to every question. The other two teams, if the direct team gives me a wrong answer, you can press the buzzer for plus 10 and minus 5. We begin with the first question for team 1, Sikkim. Here it is on your screen. From 2020, school students of which country will spend 33 hours in a year to study about climate change and sustainability, thus becoming the first country to make climate change lessons compulsory for school children? Is it A, United Kingdom? Is it B, Italy? Is it C, Japan? Or is it D, Germany?
C, Japan.
C, Japan. I'm afraid that is incorrect, but no negatives. Let's see if team Arunachal or Jharkhand is interested amongst the remaining three options for 10 points and minus 5. Do I have an answer coming from either one of you? Right, it's team Arunachal that has shown interest. Your answer is?
Option A, United Kingdom.
Option A, United Kingdom. I'm afraid that is wrong as well. That means you get a minus 5. The right answer, in fact, was Italy. So it's Italy that has decided to do this. From September 2020, they'll start with 33 hours in a year of compulsory education for students about climate change and sustainability. Team A, you get nothing, but Team C, you get a minus 5. We move on to the second question, that's for Team B, Jharkhand, on your screen. Blank is a narrow piece of land connecting two larger areas across an expanse of water by which they are otherwise separated. Is it A, peninsula? Is it B, strait? Is it C, bay? Or is it D, isthmus?
Option B, strait.
Option B, strait. I'm afraid that is incorrect. It's not the right answer. You don't get any negatives. But is Team Sikkim or is Team Arunachal Pradesh interested? Team Arunachal Pradesh, you've gone for it. Team C, your answer is?
Isthmus, option D.
You got it wrong the last time, but this time you did not get it wrong. You in fact get it right. That's the answer that I was looking for. This is indeed isthmus, of course. And that means you get 10 points. The most famous isthmus of all is Panama and of course even Suez for that matter. Good answer there. Team C gets 10 points. You got a negative earlier. This time you get positives. Strait, in fact, happens to be a body of water, not a piece of land. So that's why, Jharkhand, you get it wrong. We move on to the final question of this round, and that will be for Team C. Recently, the world's largest oil company, Saudi Aramco, joined the Zero Routine Flaring by 2030 initiative. My question is, what is flaring? Is it A, extraction of offshore oil? Is it B, transporting oil via pipeline? Or is it C, burning natural gas that cannot be used? Or finally, is it D, breaking down of complex hydrocarbons? What is flaring? Please be loud when you give me your answer. Your attempt at this question is?
Option A, extraction of offshore oil.
Option A, extraction of offshore oil is incorrect, but you don't get no negative. Sikkim, Jharkhand? I need an answer. If you're interested for 10 points, that's team Jharkhand that's hit the buzzer. What is your answer?
Option B, transporting oil via pipeline.
Option B, transporting oil via pipeline. The question says Saudi Aramco joined the zero routine flaring. So they don't want to transport oil via pipeline. That doesn't make no sense. So that's a -5 to team B. That is incorrect. The right answer is option C, burning natural gas that cannot be used. That's what flaring is. It's a great way to remove dangerous gases with lower harm to the environment. So that is what I was looking for. That's what flaring is. That's what Saudi Aramco has done recently. After round one, the scene is set for what is posing to be an evenly balanced qualifier. But two of these teams will have to shine through in round two. It's called Clutopia. 5 questions on the buzzer. Each question, you will get 3 clues. If you give me a right answer on the first clue, you get 15 points. If not, I move on to the second clue for 10 points. If not, I move on to the final clue, the third clue, for 5 points. Please remember, there's a -5 if you give me a wrong answer on the buzzer. So trust your instinct, but only if you must. If you are ready, we shall begin with our first question, first clue on your screen. The executive wing of the New Zealand Parliament, because of its shape, is also known as the blank. Fill in the blank. You see the visual? No one trying? We move on to the second clue on your screen. So it's a 7-letter answer. Starts with the letter B. What do you think it looks like? No one trying. Looks like I'll have to move on to the third clue. Third clue now on your screen. It's team C, Arunachal, that sets the buzzer. Your answer is?
Beehive.
Beehive, absolutely. That's the answer. That's a +5 to team C, Arunachal Pradesh. It is, of course, if you look at it, does that look like a beehive to you? Of course it does. Right, good answer there. Team C, that gets you 5 points. We move on to our second question, first clue. This is Ranveer Singh imitating Kapil Dev for an upcoming film called 83. While tweeting this picture, what name did he give to this shot? It's team B. Jharkhand, you've hit the buzzer. Your answer is?
Nataraj.
Nataraj, that is correct. That's the answer that I was looking for. Very good answer on the first clue. That's a 15. The Lord of Dance, Nataraj. That's how he captioned this image when Ranveer Singh tweeted this. So very good answer. Team Jharkhand, you get 15 points. We move on to our third question now. Here it is on your screen. Listen to the audio. Right, you heard the audio? My question. A 17 to 25 string lute-like instrument, its name roughly translates into beautiful sound or melody in Persian. Its origin is undocumented, but it is a combination of Senia Rabab, Afghani Rabab, and the Sursinga. My question is, please identify the instrument. You also can see its image, know what it looks like. What instrument is this? No one trying, so I move on to the second clue. It's team C, Arunachal, that has hit the buzzer. Your answer is?
Sitar.
Sitar, I'm afraid that is incorrect. That's a -5 to team C. Third clue. Who's trying for it? That's the third clue. 5 letters. I've given you the jumbled letters. Work it out, work it out. They said sitar, it's not the sitar. It's something that starts with the letter S. What instrument do you think this is? We have team Jharkhand that set the buzzer. Your answer is?
Sarod.
Sarod, absolutely. That's the answer. Very good answer. That's a +5 to team B. Right, so we move on now to our fourth question. First clue on your screen. In India, 3 prime ministers, 2 presidents and 1 vice president have died while still in office. Who was this vice president who died in 2002? Can you identify him? He died while still in office in 2002. No one trying, so I move on to the second clue for 10 points. 7 letters, 4 letters, K and K. Who is this vice president who died in 2002 while still in office? No one trying. We move on to the third clue for 5 points. I'll show you jumbled letters. Work it out. Work it out. It's team Jharkhand that has hit the buzzer for 5 and -5. Your answer is?
Krishna Kant.
Is correct. This is indeed Krishna Kant. Absolutely. Well done. The only vice president of India who's died till date while still in office. Good answer there. Team Jharkhand, you get another 5 points. And now for the final question of our first qualifier. Here it is on your screen. These are the national symbols of which country? National sport, archery, national emblem, a circle that projects a double diamond thunderbolt placed above the lotus. National bird, raven, national flower, blue poppy, and national tree, cypress. National symbols of which country? No one trying, so we move on to the second clue. 6 letters, starts with the letter B. Which country is this? National symbols. Who's trying for 10 points? Oh well, we move on to the third clue. 's team Jharkhand again. Your answer?
Bhutan.
Bhutan, of course. That is indeed Bhutan. Good answer. That's a +5 team Jharkhand. And that's the end of our first qualifier. Here the thunderbolt is actually Indra's Vajra. And that's what I was looking for. That's Bhutan. So that's the story, morning glory of our first qualifier. Let's take a look at the scores and name and fame the 2 qualifiers into the zonal final. Team A, Sikkim, finishes with a score of 0 points. Team B, Jharkhand, finishes with a score of 25. And Team C, Arunachal Pradesh, finishes with a score of 5 points. So that means doing it right for themselves are Team B, Jharkhand, and Team C, Arunachal Pradesh, who finish with a score of 25 and 5 points respectively. But hard luck to a very good team from Team Sikkim. Unfortunately, this is where your journey ends. To our viewers at home, more passion, more tension, and all the action resumes when we return with our second qualifier on the other side of this very short break. Don't go anywhere. Please don't.
Yellow.
Good news, sir. आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा.
20%, 20%.
लॉटरी लग गई. तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे लूटे डाले?
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना. 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए. रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए. 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा. बात तो वही है ना.
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जाने. पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी.
मैंने सोच लिया है, जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा.
क्यों?
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं. तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना.
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे? प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए.
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जाने. पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी.
Welcome back to a day like no other. The earth is where we meet, where we all have a mutual interest, and it's the only thing that all of us share. And sharing the stage with me here today are three teams from the East in PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2020 that has its competitions launched through various educational boards with a website designed specially for the event. Joining the two teams that qualified earlier are two more teams that will stand tall after a couple of rounds. Starting with the first of the three state winners, on table A from Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya from Mizoram are Lalampui and Lalshethlua. Then on table B from Majigram Bisweswari High School, Purva Bardhaman, West Bengal are Shiuli Bhattacharya and Kaushik Mandal. And then finally on table C from Guwahati, Assam, South Point School represented by Harinakshi Datta and Srishti Ghosh Dastidar. Promising to fight tooth and nail, there will be no time to rest. Let's quickly get underway with round one. It's called Take It Easy. There will be three multiple choice questions, one question to each team. Other teams can hit the buzzer, but wait before the direct team gives the answer. Direct team, if you give me an answer, you get 10 points, but there are no negatives. If your answer is wrong, I move on to either of the two teams that has hit the buzzer for plus 10 if you're right and minus 5 if you are wrong. Let's begin. Team 1, Mizoram, here is your question. Which country with a large cattle industry responsible for much of the world's methane emissions passed a law committing the country to net zero carbon emissions by 2050? Is it A, Canada? Is it B, Japan? Is it C, New Zealand? Or is it D, South Africa? Team West Bengal has shown interest, but they'll wait for Mizoram to give me an answer. Mizoram, I need your answer now.
D, South Africa.
D, South Africa. I'm afraid that is incorrect. That's the wrong answer. But question will now pass to Team B, West Bengal. Your answer is?
C, New Zealand.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed New Zealand. It's a country with 0.6 ton per person per year methane emission, which is the largest per capita and is 6 times above the average. That's a good answer there. Team West Bengal, you open your account with 10 points. And what's more, the second question will now be your direct on your screen. Here it comes. Which of these land masses is referred to as Sahul for convenience to study its tectonic plates? Is it A, Iceland? Is it B, Greenland? Is it C, Madagascar? Or is it D, Australia?
B, Greenland.
B, Greenland. That is incorrect, but no negative. Do I have Mizoram or Assam showing any interest on this question amongst the three remaining options? Iceland, Madagascar or Australia? Sahul. I'm trying for 10 points and minus 5. Looks like I will have to close this question. I will. The right answer is Australia. This was Australia is what I was looking for. None of you tried. Earlier, it was just called Sahul Shelf, with Greater Australia being used to refer to the continent. But since the 1970s, the term Sahul is used for the entire continent of Australia. That's what I was looking for. No points to anyone. We move on to the third question, the final question of this round. That's for Team Assam, Team C. What term is used in petroleum geology to describe the process which results in the conversion of organic kerogens into hydrocarbons? Is it A, catagenesis? Is it B, porosity? Is it C, logging? Or is it D, blowout? Team A, Assam, can I have your answer?
A, catagenesis.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed catagenesis. Good answer. Direct question, direct answer. That means Team C gets 10 points. Let me just tell you a little more about it. It's the second stage of maturation of organic carbon on the path to becoming graphitic. Right, good answer. Team C, you get 10 points, and that brings us to the end of round one. We move on to round number two. It's called Clutopia. Five questions on the buzzer. Each question will have three clues. If you give me the right answer on the first clue, you get 15. If not, I move on to the second clue for 10. And then finally to the third clue for 5 points. If you give me a right answer, if you give me a wrong answer, there's a minus 5 on either of the three clues. So if you're ready, we shall begin. The first question, first clue. P is a genus of spiders in the family Zodaridae that are found in Central and Eastern Africa. The species of P are P. alekiela, P. avonova, P. morogorom, P. obmoimiombo, and P. sinis. My question is, what does P here stand for in all these spider species? What does P stand for? Take a good look at the question. The answer is right there in front of you. What does P stand for? It's team C. Assam, you've tried?
Phylum.
Phylum. I'm afraid that is incorrect. It's a minus 5. We move on to the second clue. It's a 10-letter answer. Of course, starts with the letter P. Take a good look at the names of these spider species. What do you think is common to all of them? No one trying, so I move on to the final clue for 5 points and minus 5. Right, work it out. I'll give you some more clues. If you look at the names of the spiders, they are spelt the same way forwards as well as backwards. And that's where the word P comes from. Forwards and backwards, they're spelt the same way. What are such words called in English language? Looks like no one's taking any interest, so I will have to close this. No points to anyone. The right answer is Palindroma. If you take a good look at each of these names, Sinis, Obmoimiombo, Morogorom, Alekiela and Avonova all are spelt forwards the same way as they are spelt backwards, the palindromes, and that's the name of the genus of these spiders. Right, we move on to the second question. First clue. The blank countries generally refer to Denmark, Finland, Iceland, Norway and Sweden, including their associated territories. The term Scandinavia, however, covers Denmark, Norway and Sweden. Fill in the blank. What are these countries called? Denmark, Finland, Iceland, Norway and Sweden, along with their associated territories. What is the word that is used for these countries? If Scandinavia involves just Denmark, Norway and Sweden. No one trying, so I move on to the second clue. Starts with the letter N. 6 letters. What are such countries called? What are these countries called? Right, it's team B, West Bengal. That's it. The buzzer, your answer is?
Norway.
Norway. I'm afraid that is incorrect. It's a collective name that I'm looking for these countries. We move on to the third clue. It's a minus 5 to team B. Work it out. Starts with the letter N. What are these countries collectively called? It's team C. Assam, your answer?
Nordic.
Nordic, absolutely, that's the answer. This is indeed Nordic. These are all Nordic countries, while Scandinavian countries are just the three of them, Denmark, Norway, and Sweden. Nordic countries consist of more than just these three countries, all of them in Northern Europe. Good answer, team Assam, you get 5 points. We move on to the third question now on your screen. Fill in the blank to identify this government healthcare Iron Plus initiative launched in 2018 as part of the Poshan Abhiyan. It says blank Mukt Bharat. It's part of their Iron Plus initiative. No one trying, so I move on to the second clue for 10 points. 6 letters. Starts with the letter A. Blank Mukt Bharat. What does A stand for? 6 letters. Iron Plus initiative. Or healthcare initiative. No one trying. I move on to the third clue. Iron Plus initiative. What healthcare initiative is this of the government? It's team C. Assam again. Your answer?
Anemia.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is anemia. Anemia Mukt Bharat, that's the initiative as part of Poshan Abhiyan. Good answer there, team Assam, you get another 5-pointer. And now for the fourth question of this round on your screen, first clue. Listen to the audio.
जागो तू भी जागो जागो बांग्ला जागो बांग्ला।
Which well-known Indian personality's voice was that? Singing in her mother tongue. Who do you think she was? No one trying? I'll move on, surprisingly, to the second clue. Anyone interested? M and B, 6 and 8 letters. No, I'll move on to clue number 3. It's like teams are playing too safe. Would be hard to digest if it is missed in this part of the country. You don't really know her for her singing skills, but I found a song sung by her, and that's Team C. Assam, your answer?
Mamata Banerjee.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed Mamata Banerjee. You don't really know her for her singing skills, but I could still find her singing. Right, good answer. Team C, Guwahati, that's another 5-pointer for you. And now for the final question of our second qualifier on your screen is first clue. Three generations of a family appeared together on the cover of Vogue India August 2017 issue. The middle one, the youngest of the lot, is who you can clearly see here in the visual, is called Navya. What surname does she share with the other two ladies whose faces aren't visible, but they appeared in a photo shoot together in Vogue India August 2017 issue? Three generations of the same family. What is the common surname? No one trying, so I move on to the second clue for 10 points. Starts with the letter B, 8 letters in all. What very well-known family from India? What surname is this? 8 letters. Still no answer, I move on to the final clue. It's Team C, Assam again.
Bachchan.
Bachchan, so who do you think they are? You don't know, and you don't want to guess either, but you did guess Bachchan. On the left is Jaya, on the right is Shweta, in the middle is Navya. Of course, that's the answer, the Bachchan family, the three generations of Bachchan family. That's a good answer there, Team Assam, getting back-to-back 5-pointers. Right, that's the end of the second round as well. The game can be as cruel as it can be kind. Kind for which two teams and cruel for which one? The scoreboard will tell us. Finishing with no points at all is Team A from Mizoram. Team B, West Bengal, you finish with a score of 5 points. And Team C from Assam, you finish with a score of 30. So that means it's Team West Bengal and Team Assam that will continue the journey in the Eastern Zonal Final. And unfortunately and sadly, Team Mizoram will take the long road back home. Now, amongst Jharkhand, Arunachal, West Bengal and Assam, is hidden the team that qualifies to Delhi for the national final. Your guess is as good as mine. So guess all you want, sip some water if you like as we take a short break. See you in a bit.
Yellow.
Good news, sir. आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा।
20%, 20%।
लॉटरी लग गई। तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे लूट डाले?
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना। 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए, रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए। 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा।
बात तो वही है ना।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
मैंने सोच लिया है, जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा।
क्यों?
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं, तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना।
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे? प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए।
PCRA का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
Mind, active, intention, victorious, and Josh, high. Welcome back to PCRA Presents Saksham Quiz Contest 2020. The Indian Energizers are fully charged to win the Eastern Zonal Final, so we'll go full throttle on track. A quick reminder for our viewers, the qualifying teams are Team A from Jharkhand with a score of 25 points. Then on Table B from West Bengal is with 5 points. Then on Table C from Assam with a score of 30 points. And finally, we have on Table D, Arunachal Pradesh, with a score of 5 points. So these teams vow to wow us with their knowledge over a matter of 2 rounds. And in return, I promise to reward the ticket to Delhi to the one that does it a little more than the others. Let's begin round number 1. It's called How's That? I will display 5 topics on screen. These teams have been paired as per their qualifying scores. These teams have been paired as per seedings based on their qualifying scores. So that means it's Jharkhand versus Assam and Arunachal Pradesh versus West Bengal. One team will bat, the other team will bowl. The bowling team will pick a topic for the batting team. And when they do that, the batting team will give an answer for 10 points if they're correct. But if they're wrong, the question goes back to the bowling team for +5 if they're right and -5 to the batting team. But if both of them do not answer, the question is open for the other two teams who were spectators till now on the buzzer for +10 and -5. So here are the topics on screen. Team Jharkhand, please pick a topic for Team Assam.
Precipitation.
For Team Assam, here is your question. Since the Industrial Revolution, emissions of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxides into the atmosphere have increased. And in 1852, Robert Anger Smith showed the relationship between pollution and a mixture of sulfur dioxide and nitrous oxide. What phenomenon is this, whose effect was first seen in the 17th century? Your topic is precipitation. What is this phenomenon called? Something that impacts or harms the environment whenever it happens. Yes, Assam, your answer?
Acid rain.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed acid rain. So that's a ball that was hit out of the park. Good answer. And that gets you 10 points, Team Assam. Well done. Now, Team Assam, your job is not done. You have to pick a topic and bowl to Team Jharkhand. What topic do you want to bowl to Team Jharkhand?
Mountains.
Mountains? Question to Team Jharkhand. Here it is on your screen. Among many names this mountain has is the name Savage Mountain. After George Bell, a climber on a 1953 American expedition, told reporters, "It's a savage mountain that tries to kill you," and that's why it got the name Savage Mountain. Which mountain is this that has inclement weather and a huge difference from base to peak? As opposed to some of the other mountains whose base is not that low, but this mountain has a huge difference from base to the peak. It's called, also called Savage Mountain. But which mountain is this that we're talking about? There are 2 or 3 names of this mountain. You can give me either one of them. I will accept.
Mount K2.
Mount K2, also known as Goodwin Austin, also known as Mount Chagori. All of that is correct. That's the answer. Good answer. So that's an all-round performance by both Assam and Jharkhand answering their questions respectively. And both of them get 10 points. That's well done to the both of you. It's a stalemate. But let's see what happens in the next set of questions when Arunachal Pradesh plays against West Bengal. West Bengal, you have to pick a topic for Team Arunachal Pradesh. What topic will it be?
Soil.
Soil? All right, here it is. Team D, your question. This soil provides most productive agricultural land and thereby supporting large population of India. It is formed mainly due to silt deposited by Indo-Gangetic Brahmaputra rivers. What kind of soil is this whose name literally means to wash against? Team Jharkhand has shown interest, but they will wait. Yes. Team D?
Loamy soil.
is incorrect. I will go back to Team West Bengal. If you get it right, you get 5 points and Team B gets a minus five. What is your answer? No? Nothing at all? So that means Jharkhand for plus 10 and minus 5.
Alluvial soil.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed alluvial soil. Good answer, Team Jharkhand. Pouncing on a question for the other two teams. Not a spectator after all. 10 points. And now for the final question of this round. That's going to be Team Arunachal picking a topic for West Bengal. Now, come on, Arunachal. Try to Bumrah them, Shammi them, Ishant them. How will you bowl to them?
Engineering.
Engineering? Right. West Bengal, here's your question. In 1849, British-American engineer James Francis developed the first modern equipment, the Francis turbine, for this purpose. And since then, it has been used as a major equipment for what renewable source of energy? What source of energy is this? No answer. Goes back to Arunachal. Can you get this one?
Sir, water.
What renewable source of energy would that be? If you're saying water, what is the source of energy or the power generated called?
Hydro power.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed hydroelectric power. That's a good answer from Team Arunachal Pradesh. What that does is it works in your favor and not quite in West Bengal's favor, because Arunachal gets plus 5 and West Bengal, you get a minus 5. Right? So that brings us to the end of round 1. It's a defining fixture this over the years for Saksham, the Eastern Zonal Final. Currently, it's living up to the hype. Let's see if it can sustain over round 2. We move on to the final round of today's episode. It's called Double Trouble. I will give you 6 questions on the buzzer. If you give me an answer, you get 10 points. If you're right, but if you're wrong, you get a minus 5. The round is called Double Trouble, so you can double for 20 points if you are right before you give me your answer. But the trouble is, if you give me a wrong answer, that's a minus 20. And there will be, if needed, multiple attempts on the same question by different teams. Not the same team repeating their answer till they finally get it right, but once per team, but multiple times on the same question. If you're ready, we shall begin with our first question of the 6. On your screen, here it comes. A Space of Their Own is a new online database that features works by over 600 artists from 15th to 19th century. The paintings, prints, and sculptures were discovered in museum storage spaces throughout Florence in Italy. What is common to these artists? Who are these artists? They're all the same group of people. What group of people I'm talking of? All of them the same kind. In fact, the name Space of Their Own comes from Virginia Woolf's feminist text, A Room of One's Own. That's how the name A Space of Their Own comes. It's a brainchild of Jane Fortune, created because of lack of visibility of such artists in the existing galleries. What is common to all these artists? What group of people are these? A Space of Their Own. Over 600 artists. Any team showing interest? Looks like no one is. So I'll close this question. As I announced in the hints that I gave, these were all artists who've been underrepresented in most of the traditional galleries that exist across the world. All 600 of them were women. Right? These were all women artists. So A Space of Their Own, coming from Virginia Woolf's text. Right, no points to anyone. Doesn't matter, 5 more questions to go. We move on to question number 2 on the buzzer. Watch the video, question follows.
The fielder is underneath. And has he caught it?
Oh, that's a fine catch.
The captain's delighted, and so are his fans.
The situation seems tense for the batting team.
Right. My question, voiced by Harsha Bhogle and Shibani Dandekar, what event in Australia is this tourism campaign about? What event in Australia is this tourism campaign about? Those were the voices of Harsha Bhogle and Shibani Dandekar, who you often hear in a particular sport generally when watching a particular sport. It's an event that will be held in 2020 in Australia. Right, it's Team Jharkhand that's gone for it. Your answer is?
T20 World Cup.
Is correct. That's the answer. This is indeed the T20 World Cup that will be held in 2020 in Australia. Jharkhand knew this, and as a result, they only get 10. Right. Good answer though. 10 nevertheless. Four questions remain. Here is question number 3. The lady on the left was shortlisted for the Booker Prize for Clear Light of Day, In Custody and Fasting Feasting. But it was the lady on the right who eventually won for the Inheritance of Loss on behalf of the family. What is the shared surname of this literary pair? I'm just looking for the surname. What surname is shared by this literary mother-daughter pair? It was the daughter on the right that finally won it, the Booker Prize, for the Inheritance of Loss. No one trying, so I'll give you the first names. Let me see if you can give me the surname. Anita and Kiran. Team Jharkhand, your answer?
Desai.
Is correct. That's the answer. Anita Desai and Kiran Desai. Good answer there. Yet again, Team Jharkhand, that's another 10-pointer. Now, three questions remain. Here is question number 4. Some comics at the time. DC Superman was one of the biggest comic books out there. And Stan Lee, the creator of Spider-Man, was worried that because Spider-Man also wore blue and red colors and has a name that starts with the letter S, he felt that, you know, he would be lost and people wouldn't pay too much attention to Spider-Man. So he did something in the naming of his superhero, Spider-Man, to avoid confusion on newsstands. What did he do with the naming of or branding of Spider-Man in order to prevent any kind of confusion happening for regular customers when checking out these comics on magazine stands? Take a good look at the visual. The answer is right there. Just have to identify what it is. It's Team C. Assam, who's gone for it? Your answer?
Marvel.
So what is it that was done with Spider-Man, with his naming? What about Marvel? He was, of course, Marvel's character as opposed to DC. So how was the naming any different? Why would you say Marvel? It's just the parent company and for whom Stan Lee created it. Anyway. There's no clear logic because that's not the right answer. That's a -5 to Team Assam. Right, either of the other three teams interested? How did he change the naming around? For Spider-Man, take a good look at the visual. The answer is right there. What did he do? Right, so nobody getting this one. As is pretty evident from the visual, there's a hyphen in the name of Spider-Man, which is not quite there in the name of Superman. And till before he died, Stan Lee was very particular and he really hated it if he found any publication not having a hyphen in the name of Spider-Man. And hard luck to Team C for getting a wrong answer on that. So you get a -5. Nevertheless, two questions remain. 40 points still to be won. As I don't think I have a clear winner. So we move on to question number 5. These are Sloan letters, which were designed by Lewis Sloan in 1959 for use in Slennen charts and Logmar charts. Where would you have come across these letters? Team Jharkhand?
Double it.
You'd like to double for +20 and a very crucial and a very interesting note for the others, -20 if you get it wrong. Right, Jharkhand, what is your answer?
at the clinic of an eye doctor?
Is correct. That's the answer. During an eye test, right, when you visit an optometrist, absolutely, Team Jharkhand gets this correct. I can speak from personal experience. Team Jharkhand can speak about this from personal experience. That is why he could answer. Good answer there, Team Jharkhand. That is a plus 20, right? Here we are now for the final question of today's zonal final on your screen. This is an installation in the museum located right next to which very famous world monument? Mohins, it's a globally renowned monument from 19th century. So it's been around for over 130 years. It was a gift given to one country by another country. This is actually the mold used to create the face of this monument, of this tourist landmark. This is located on an island. Right, it's always one-way traffic in this round, so this time it's yet again Jharkhand. What is your answer?
Statue of Liberty.
Statue of Liberty, located on the Liberty Island off the coast of New York City. Absolutely, that's the answer. Very well done, so smooth, so sharp, splendid quizzing by Jharkhand and all the other participants. Kept me on my toes throughout. I was so nervous, I felt like a participant. But trust me, I wouldn't have done 10% of what these participants have done today. Here's a final look at the scorecard. Team B, West Bengal, unfortunately couldn't make a mark on the scorecard. They finished with a score of 0. Team D from Arunachal Pradesh, you finished with a score of 10. And Team C, Assam, you finished with a score of 35. Pretty impressive, each one of you. But today, there could only have been one winner. And that winner came from Guru Gobind Singh Public School, Jharkhand, with a score of 95 points. Congratulations, Harshul and Arvind. May I request both of you to please come forward and collect your prize from our guests, Mr. Raj Narayan Datta, Director and Chief Regional Director, Eastern Region PCRA, Mr. Narayan Naskar, Additional Director, PCRA Eastern Region, and Mr. Vinod Kumar, Additional Director, PCRA from Delhi Headquarters. May I request all three of you to please come up on stage and present the award to our winners. Team Jharkhand to come forward and collect your prize. Congratulations. Please let the applause continue. Phenomenal achievement.
Really, it's a happy moment that our younger generation, I was just watching, everyone, they are so knowledgeable and they are so aware of this thing, that what is going on. Actually, we are in the society, what we are doing actually, we are percolating the message of the reason, the cause and the way and means of energy conservation. And our aim is just to spread this thing, just to hand over this torch to our younger generation. So really, it is. I have seen this from all four states. I won't say that they have represented their school only. They have represented their states. We hope that in future also we'll get more participation in this sort of program, and we hold this thing, this sort of program, like youth program in different schools and colleges. And I think then more and more program we can do in such schools, and we can reach to the remotest corner of these states. So with this thing, I thank you for this thing, for Doordarshan, for organizing such a good event.
Please let the applause continue. Winners in your respective states. Thank you, sirs. Thank you so very much. Thank you. To our viewers at home, दादरा एंड नगर हवेली, आंध्र प्रदेश और झारखंड से हमें हमारी तिकड़ी मिल चुकी है। जरूरत है सक्षम नेशनल फाइनल पजल के आखिरी हिस्से की, जो आएगा नॉर्थ से। तो अगले एपिसोड में खूब जमेगा रंग जब मिल बैठेंगे तीन यार, आप, मैं और इंडियन नर्चरर्स। दिस इज अजय पुनिया थैंकिंग यू फ्रॉम द बॉटम ऑफ माई हार्ट, फ्रॉम दूरदर्शन स्टूडियोज कोलकाता, फ्रॉम पीसीआर रिप्रेजेंट्स सक्षम क्विज कॉन्टेस्ट 2020। होगी हमारी मुलाकात अगले एपिसोड में, जरूर आइएगा।
मैंने सोच लिया है, जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना, तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा।
क्यों?
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं, तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना।
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे? प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए।
पीसीआरए का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
ये लो।
गुड न्यूज सर, आज से आपको पेट्रोल पे 20% का डिस्काउंट मिलेगा।
20%? 20%?
लॉटरी लग गई तो मेरे बाकी के पैसे क्यों डाले?
वो तो आपके हाथ में ना। 45 की स्पीड पे गाड़ी चलाइए, रेड लाइट पे इंजन ऑफ कर दीजिए, 20% पेट्रोल तो जरूर बचेगा। बात तो वही है ना।
पीसीआरए का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।
मैंने सोच लिया है, जब मैं बड़ा हो जाऊंगा ना, तब मैं साइकिल रिपेयर की दुकान खोलूंगा।
क्यों?
जिस तरह आप सब पेट्रोल वेस्ट कर रहे हैं, फ्यूचर में तो पेट्रोल बचेगा ही नहीं, तब तो सब साइकिल ही चलाएंगे ना।
खुद ही सारा पेट्रोल खत्म करेंगे या कुछ अपने बच्चों के लिए भी छोड़ेंगे? प्लीज कम से कम सिग्नल पे तो इंजन ऑफ कीजिए।
पीसीआरए का एंड्रॉइड ऐप डाउनलोड करें और ईंधन बचाने के उपाय जानें। पेट्रोलियम संरक्षण अनुसंधान संघ, पेट्रोलियम एवं प्राकृतिक गैस मंत्रालय, भारत सरकार द्वारा जनहित में जारी।